Thank you. lead? What's going on? Am I that transparent?
What do you want, Raleigh?
We're friends, right?
Yes.
Do you think Alpha is real?
What makes you... Why would you ask that?
I think Ross is trying to tell me something.
About Side Alpha?
He wants me to go down to the Abyss and find him. Crazy, right? You've been down there. I just thought you could talk some sense into me.
Raleigh, I'm not at liberty to... I can't talk about that.
Thank you. Johan Ross was found dead on climber this morning. The ARC team went down a couple of days ago, but I see no reason to suspect them playing a part in his death. The climber can't be operated from the abyss, so there was a scheduled retrieval. The climber returned with only the lifeless body of Alpha member Johan Ross. No traces of the ARC team. Cameron, Eames, Lansky, all studying the body inside containment. I'll follow up with whatever they find. Delenda S. The WoW has been getting more aggressive, pushing all systems to their limits. Ironically, the dead Dr. Johan Ross would be the perfect person to ask why the WoW is making such a big buzz about his passing. After all, the WoW isn't supposed to want anything, and definitely not to mourn people. The system overload affects the staff considerably. Headaches, loss of sleep, unwarranted stress. And it seems to be getting worse. I could use some advice if you can get through. Delenda Est. Things are out of hand. The staff looks like they're about to explode. Every other person walks around with nosebleeds, and the rest keep wiping stains of blood from their eyes to keep them from overflowing. That's to do with the WoW trying to free Ross somehow, for sure. At this point, I wouldn't be surprised if the body just got up and left. Rally Herber, our dispatcher, has been snooping around asking questions she shouldn't. She says she's going down into the abyss to find Alpha. I can't bring myself to stop her.
Lock it up!
What's happening?
Lock the door!
It's locked! What's going on?
I managed to piss off another one of Wow's monsters.
We have everything we need, right?
Yeah. Let's get to work. Crazy.
Don't worry, it'll work. Make sure it's all bunched together with the structure gel connecting all the parts. All right, try activating the seat from the terminal again.
I can't believe we're doing this.
It will be fine.
Then why don't we put you in the suit?
I was gonna suggest that if you refused.
You'd go without me.
I need to do this, Simon. This is important. I need to launch the Ark.
You'd really do it, change body?
Yes. If you want to stay here, I'm not gonna stand in your way. I don't want to tell you what to do.
What would it be like before? Close my eyes and then...
And then open them again.
All right. Let's do it.
Thank you, Simon. Go sit in the pilot seat in the next room. You might need to boot it up. The activity manifested by your current cortex chip, run it through the amplifier, feed it into the new chip, and then make sure it's synced.
You lost me halfway there.
You don't really need to understand it. Just make them line up. That's everything. You can climb into the pilot seat now.
Already?
I have everything under control, so please, have a seat. Go sit in the pilot. Sorry about any discomfort. This should be over soon.
It's like having your picture taken.
But with the most expensive camera in the world.
You know, Indians thought photos would steal their souls.
In this case, they'd be right.
What was that?
No, it just...
Why was it still talking?
It's the same like before.
Catherine, why was he still talking?
That's how it works, you know that.
What do you mean?
You know it's not magic. You were copied. The sleeping Simon in the seat was copied, and now you are here, just like Simon lived on in Toronto.
God damn you, Kath. Two Simons? There can't be two Simons.
What did you think would happen?
That you were gonna take my mind and put it into another body, like a brain transplant.
I'm sorry, it wouldn't work that way.
You realize how messed up this is?
Please, I didn't mean to upset
you. How did you expect me to react to this shit?
Please stop.
You're fucking disgusting. What's gonna happen to him?
He'll sleep for a while, a few days.
And then what? Wake up in this fucking nightmare again? All alone? So cruel.
Well, what do you want me to do with him? Make friends? Let him know that we have to leave him behind when we go into the abyss?
What if he didn't need to wake up?
You'd do that?
I don't know. Maybe.
There. I set it up for you. Hit the switch if you want to drain his battery. He'll die within a minute. I'd rather not stay plugged in any longer.
Are we done here?
Yeah.
Activate the clamor, please.
Sure thing.
Take a seat and we'll be off.
we figured out what happens when we die yet? Is that even possible? If there's some kind of afterlife, do you think my place is taken? The real me died like 100 years ago. Is there still room for me? And what about the Simon I killed at Omicron? What do you think, Catherine? Is there a heaven full of redundant copies of the same people? Is there someone up there who called me an imposter? It's dumb luck, right? That I woke up in the right body. I basically flipped a coin, and if I had called the wrong side, I'd be rotting away at Omicron. I mean, there's nowhere to know, right? You didn't hit the make sure Simon wakes up in the right body switch, did you? Not that you would know. I mean, he would still claim to be the right Simon. Christ! This is awful. We did an awful fucking thing. And you wouldn't mind? Why would you? How could you know that it's not me, the me that I am, the same that I've always been? Please say something. I don't want to think. Please.
I don't know what to say. I don't want to upset you.
Say anything.
When I was little, I used to climb the stairs all the way to the top of the building. And I could still feel how I had to, you know, tuck my arm so I could push the heavy steel door open. Well, the first time that I dared go up there, I stepped out onto the roof and watched the smog rise and fall over Taipei. I got all the way up to the corner ledge and, you know, I felt the warm wind in my hair and the sun was setting and the streets below were shadowed by the tall buildings. The people pushing through the crowd flowed like paint from an artist's brush. Street food vendors filled the air with aromas of all my favorite foods. For a brief moment, I felt connected to the world in a way that I never had before. It was the most profound feeling of comfort and sense of belonging I could ever hope for. I really never felt the same way again, but I went up to the roof many times after. I'm not religious, but I can see why people would be. The privilege of being makes a strong case, at least every once in a while.
Do you still feel that sense of awe? Even like this?
Things are different, but we're still here.
What's the point of going on? Everyone's gone. All the people still left are digital copies trapped in computers at the bottom of the sea. We'll never be able to rebuild or reclaim what we were.
Are you really so unhappy being what you are, or is this about the man who went for a scan 100 years ago?
Both, I guess. When I was back in Toronto, even the worst case, the darkest futures I could predict, they at least included my previous life somehow. I feel so uprooted. There's nothing here that I recognize, nothing that makes me feel like I belong. Even if we make it to the Ark, would it be any different? Still be alone. No friends. No family.
You could make new friends. I'm sure everyone would like to know the time traveler. If not, you still have...
Catherine? Kath? Hello, Catherine. What happened?
I know it's not much, but why have we stopped moving?
The power blacked out for a moment. Think it could be the atmospheric pressure. It's pushing pretty hard, really testing the limits of my suit.
Don't worry, it should hold.
Comforting.
It will hold.
time freeze when you're not powered?
Time feels omitted more than human.
What's the difference?
I don't feel like I'm being held back or hindered. And I don't have the opportunity to reflect on the time I'm missing. It's simply missing.
Sounds like sleeping without the dreaming.
Yes. But generally you anticipate when you're about to sleep, and there's a natural continuation since we tend to wake up where we went to sleep. My experience is more like an ever-changing moment that never really seems to find closure.
Sounds kind of like a movie being edited live.
I suppose so. I guess it sounds exciting, but it really keeps me activated to the point of exhaustion.
It's rough.
Could be worse. Could be a time traveler stuck in a body made from black goo.
That'd be the worst. Preparations. I don't like the sound of that.
It was very strange. I thought it was gonna kill you for sure. Glad it didn't.
Yeah, me too. Looks like we're closing in on the ocean floor.
Good, not sure the climber can take it much longer. Okay, so this is the Omega Sector. It's about an acre of the abyssal plan used by Pathos 2. I expect we'll have to do some walking before we reach town.
You haven't been here before?
Not in a way that'll help us.
Right, the other you has been here. We're following your old footsteps, Kat.
When I had footsteps.
You could still be down here somewhere, technically.
Don't remind me, freaks me out. All right, let's head for town and find that arc.
Tao. Please answer, Tao. Nothing. It's dead.
Let's move out. We'll try the next one.
Stick to the lamplights. They won't go near them.
I can't fail, Glasser. It's important I reach Omicron. Our future depends on it.
Calm down. Let's just follow the path.
If I die, I need you to tell Julia Dahl that the WoW is out of control. She needs to get to Sarang. He'll know what to do.
Roz, you can tell him yourself. We just need to pick up the pace, okay?
Glass! We lost the path! We need to go back!
I know where to go. Come on!
It's over there! The light is over there!
Final push, Ross. Almost there, we
just...